Hello, everyone. Good evening. Welcome to our yin class. Let's begin with being on our mat. And our theme for our class is energy, having harmony in the energies flowing through our body. So sitting in easy pose, usually we have our dominant leg in front. So noticing that. So we're just going to settle in easy pose. If crossing your knees, it doesn't work for you, crossing your legs doesn't work for you, you can sit on a chair too. Just find where it's comfortable for you. Place one hand onto your heart center and then one onto your belly. Let your shoulders soften. A nice Ujjayi breath that is softer breath. So the Ujjayi breath, breathing in through the nose and out through the nose, it's just not as strong, but still feeling it coming into the back of your throat. You may close your eyes and breathe. So here we are bringing our energies back into harmony. And it is represented by the elements of the earth. So here, as we breathe in easy pose and let ourselves feel the stillness, allow yourself to be fully present, feeling the physical sensations run through your body. Allow your thoughts to come and go freely. We feel our chest, our abdomen open with our inhale breath. Release, let go with the exhale breath. And as we breathe in to our body, feel the front, feel the sides, feel the back of our body open. Feeling that deep belly breath. Now again, the energies flowing through our body represented by the elements of the earth. We will touch on each of them. And we open our eyes if they were closed. You may release your hands down, so turning your palms up towards the sky. And then take your hands down towards the sides and crossing your legs. We cross our legs the opposite way, so the opposite foot coming in front. Do a little shift through the body. And then once again, we come into stillness. Place your hands together and let's just rub them together. We're going to create some heat energy. I want you to hear your hands being rubbed together. In 3 seconds, we shall place them onto a body part. So here we go. In 3, 2, 1. Where would they like to go? I want you to just breathe. We release our hands and we can place them back to our knees. The first element we shall be touching on is the wood element, coming down towards the ground. So we're going to come down towards the side of our body and lie down on the ground. Roll over to your back. We take one knee and then the other knee in towards our chest here first. We come into a supine twist. So bring the legs up and over to the side, bringing your arms in line with the shoulders. You may turn your head the opposite way. Now the wood element is our relationship with control, planning, and order. Finding harmony in our wood element with our poses that we move through the first part. Now we hold our yin poses for longer periods of time. This twist we shall hold for another minute. Notice your breath. Is it an even breath? Are we able to let ourselves go? Release. Out of the twist, we turn our head back towards the center, and then we bring our legs up towards the center, and now bring your legs over to the other side. Our arms come back in line with the shoulders, and again, you may turn your head the opposite way of the knees. Your arms can be straight, or you could have the elbow bend. Now, when we think of the wood element, we're thinking about, again, our relationship with planning, order, control, knowing that, of course, we need organization in our life, but being able to be flexible, having a balance. We hold for a little bit longer. Bring your head back to the center. And now bringing our legs back to the center. Nice and strong. And let your knees come into the chest hold. Balanced on both sides. We stay lying on our back for cow face pose. You may do cow face seated, but this one will lie on our back just to stay here, just let our back settle into the ground. We open up through the legs into a V and then cross your right leg over top of the left leg. Now having our knees one over top of the other, that is the goal. So just notice where you're at. So doing what is accessible to you, you may hold on to the knees, you can hold on to opposite ankles. If your hip flexors are really tight right now, and then come out of the pose, you can windshield wiper knees side to side. Now again, we are present, feeling the sensations running through our body. We let our thoughts pass one by one. Come back to your breath, turning inward. Use your breath to help. The inhale and the exhale breath, the Ujjayi breath, feeling the inhale breath, exhale breath into the back of the throat. We breathe in the inhale breath as if you're breathing in through the straw, a straw. And coming out of cow face pose, we release and open up the legs. And all these poses, we make our way through slowly, open up the legs back into a V. And now this time, we cross the left leg over top of the right leg. Now again, remember the goal, having those knees stacked on top of each other. You can hold on to the knees. Or knee, you may hold on to ankles. Let your ankles release down to the ground. And hold, finding stillness. Breathe. Make your way out of our cow face pose. So releasing your hands and crossing your legs. Your legs will come into a V. And then bring them back to the center. Put one foot and then the other foot down towards the ground. Take your feet wider than the hips. And here, bring your arms in line with the shoulders. We twist, so windshield wiper, your knees side to side. And you can turn your head the opposite way of the knees as you do the windshield wiper. And bringing our knees, head back to the center. Okay, now we step in one foot and then the other foot. Take one knee into the chest, the other knee into the chest. Give yourself a little squeeze and then float right foot, left foot down. Bring your right arm overhead and roll over to your right side to fetal. And make your way up into our next pose. Our next pose shall be swan. I'm going to show you what figure four looks like too. Should have actually showed you on the ground too, but so just let me show you while you're upright. So you can come back down towards the ground and you can do figure four lying on your back. You're crossing your ankle over top of the left knee. You may thread the needle and take the foot off the floor and you can hold. So this is an option for the pose that we are going to be doing. So it's sleeping swan. This is for our next element, which is the earth element. And so when we think of the earth element, we think of being grounded. So come in to swan with me if you like, or coming into figure four, which I showed you lying on your back. So on all fours, you may step your right hand, left hand forward into downward facing dog. Now into three-legged dog, I'm on the balls of my feet. I lift my right leg up towards the sky and then bend through the knee. Take my knee to my right wrist, turn my knee out. So turn my knee out. Come to the right wrist. Now here we are upright. You may, if you have your props handy, place a pillow underneath of the right hip. And I am definitely very dark in this screen, so this is going to be good for you to be able to see what it looks like here with my gray pillow, that my hip is resting and my hips are square. So now setting yourself up so that you are able to release into this pose. Now we can come into swan, sleeping swan. Let the forehead rest. Your hips soften. To let your hips soften a little bit more, then curl the toes and let your body release into the ground. Again, we're breathing, feeling those physical sensations run through our body. It is an opening up through the right side of our hip. And with our forehead being rested to the ground, resting on something, it will help us to feel grounded. Continue to breathe three more cycles of breath. The inhale, exhale being one cycle of breath. coming out of sleeping swan or figure four. If you're in figure four, you can just bring your knees into the chest. Coming out of sleeping swan, we make our way back into downward facing dog, and then just bend your knees and come to all fours. Take your pillow, your prop to the other side, and now back to all fours and into downward facing dog. So step forward with the right hand, left hand, and we come into downward facing dog, three-legged dog, left leg lifts, bend with the knee and turn your knee out to the left wrist. Okay, and we place our pillow underneath of the left hip. You may, of course, come to figure four, lying on your back. Now, coming into sleeping swan, we lower our body down in towards the ground. I still have my toes down towards the ground. When my hips are square, I'm able to uncurl the toes, let my hips sink a little bit deeper. Here we let our forehead rest and breathe. Breathing just a little bit longer. Notice your breath. And coming out of sleeping swan or figure four. If you're in figure four, and remain lying on your back, taking one knee and the other knee into the chest. Now, you may come out of sleeping swan, back into downward facing dog. And then bending through the knees. And everyone making their way to child's pose. So with child's pose, uncurling the toes, sitting back into the heels, your knees may be going towards the front, or your knees could be turned out to sides of your mat. So finding what is going to work for you. Your arms could be forward, could be by the sides of the body. See if you can let that forehead rest again. Just feeling your pelvis open, feeling centered, balanced, and we release.
Coming out of child's pose, make your way up. Now this pose, it may not work for you. It is reclined saddle that you could do on your own. So I'm just going to show you a version of reclined saddle. So we sit on our heels, or you're taking your heels out towards the sides. That is a deeper pose. Now you can have your bottom down towards the center, or you're going to sit on a block. And sitting on a block, it is easier on your knees. So you could sit on something like that. Now it could be a pillow too, that you're sitting on something. Now remember, this may or may not work for your knees. We're not going to be holding this pose for as long. But yes, it definitely does help to sit on something. Now we take our hands behind, and I'm going to lift up my hips, and my tailbone is not going straight down. It's on an angle. And we lift our heart up towards the sky. Another inhale breath coming up. And exhale, release. Okay. Now taking the block from underneath and moving it over to the side. And you can sit on the side of your body, finding what's going to work for you, of course. Into our next element. We move into supported bridge for the metal element. Now the metal element, let's set ourselves up here for supported bridge. Now this is for the metal element. We have supported bridge with a pillows underneath of our hips, or you're going to use a block. And I do have my blocks handy here. So if you do still have that block or pillow handy, finding where it's going to be placed underneath of your hips. And then just let your sacrum rest. You don't have to use a block if you don't want. You can just watch me first here. If you don't have a block, you would lift your hips up and then walking your elbows under and hold your hips. And then just like this. When you are in the supported bridge, we don't look around. Your head is up towards the sky. So what is going to be able to work for you? Take the time to set yourself up. Now, our metal element, once we've set up this pose for herself, it is about taking in what is good for us and letting go, releasing what we do not need, negative energy. So we take in what is going to serve us in a positive way, and we let go. Everything that does not serve us. feel this openness in your physical body, the openness in the front, hips, chest, our shoulders. The letting go, the releasing, we are able to release our physical body. We are able to let go, feeling ourselves supported. Coming out of supported bridge, we continue to look upward and release the prop underneath from our pelvis. Let your pelvis settle. Then you can take one knee and then the other knee into the chest. And just do a little side to side movement here. Take your right foot, left foot down towards the ground. And windshield wiper knees side to side. So you have to step your feet out wider than the hips, and then you can do the windshield. Your arms come in line with the shoulders. You can turn your head the opposite way of the knees. Come back to center. Step your feet in and then take your right arm overhead and then roll over to your right side and a nice strong push. We make our way up to our next pose. It is caterpillar. For our next pose, we have pillows that we could use. Turn towards the front of your mat, both legs straight forward. Now we put our prop, our pillows over top of our legs. I'm just gonna show you with my gray pillow so you can see what I'm doing. Now, put your pillows on top and we lift our chest up. With a nice big inhale breath, we come up and over. Now, let the forehead rest or let your cheek rest. We've now moved into the water element, this pose. The water element, we think of water that it flows. And the water element has to do with how we deal with life's challenges, stresses. When we come face to face with a challenge, a stress, knowing that we may not be able to control everything, and it's okay. But knowing that also you are in charge, and we are not going to let those challenges, those stresses that we encounter, Let them be the ones that are in charge, knowing that we are. Out of caterpillar, we lift nice and slow. And take our props over to the side and make our way to half dragonfly. Dragonfly is when we have our legs into a V. So you can do that first, sitting in a V. And now we tuck our right foot in towards the left inner thigh. We shall still make our way down into the center. So we're not going to come over top of our leg. So with a nice inhale breath, we lift. And the exhale breath, we fold. So notice here again, it is opening up into our back, the lower back. We let ourselves release into this fold, opening up into our inner thighs. And this is the water element pose. Again, we are in charge. If you wanted to use pillows and place them in front of you and then do the fold over, please do so. Feeling your body, physical body supported. Coming out of half dragonfly and lifting, we make our way to the other side for half dragonfly. So releasing the right leg and we open up into the V. Take your left foot and place it into the inner thigh. So a nice inhale breath, we lift, and again you can have pillow in front, exhale breath, you come up and over. You can have your elbows down and let the forehead rest. You could stack your pillows on top of each other and then bring your body up and over. Turning inward, breathe. out of half dragonfly. We make way back up to our last element now. Take our prop to the side. And our last element is the fire element. And our fire element is, if we are balanced in our fire element, then we feel loving and we feel spontaneous. So it says love, the opening up to the heart, and we think of fire, we think of passion, love. So we come to melting heart for fire element, so we can open up through our heart. So to all fours, and we have a big step forward with the right hand, a big step forward with the left hand, draw the forearms down, keeping your hips over top of the knees. We let our forehead rest. Let your heart be drawn down. So with letting our forehead rest, we let go. Melting heart, slowly release, coming back and sitting on your bottom. Now we had half dragonfly when we brought one foot in towards the inner thigh. Now we'll have dragonfly, the whole dragonfly, so it is a V sit. You can bring your pillows in front. So come into a V sit, we open up through the legs. Now you can bring the pillows again in towards the inner thighs. I'm going to tuck my pillow right in towards my groin. And we sit up tall with a nice inhale breath, the exhale breath. Add the fold forward, let the forehead rest. Our shoulders soften. Thinking of loving thoughts, letting go of fear, anger, anxiety. Just a little bit longer, dragonfly. Coming out of dragonfly. Way up. Just walking back. You have a prop. You can remove it. Take your hands behind. Take your legs in front. You may want to windshield wiper knee side to side. We are now moving into Shavasana. Shavasana, we can place warm clothes, a blanket on top of our body. So if you wanted to put socks on, something to cover the front of your body, your chest here, please do so. And you have time to get yourself ready. So blanket. You may be in a seated position, or you can come onto your back lying down. And if you choose that option, lying on your back, you may have your knees bent or legs straight. You could also have the legs up or legs up the wall. You take one ankle to one corner of the mat and then the other ankle to the other corner of the mat so you're open. And squeeze your glutes and then let them release. Your arms by the side of the body. Also have them a little bit further away from the body. Another option would be lying on the side of your body. And we let our eyes close. We let our body soften and let go. Breath is natural. Of the energies that are flowing through the body, how they are brought together in harmony so that we can feel whole, balanced, calm, centered. We again allow our thoughts to come and go freely. I will call you back when it is time.
Coming back. Notice sounds around you. Surface you're lying on. Any smells in the air? You notice our breath. Wiggling your toes, wiggling your fingers, may do a shift through the body. If you're lying on your back, bending your right knee, left knee, and bringing your right arm overhead and rolling over to the right side to fetal, and let yourself take a moment here. And then making your way up, sitting in a comfortable space spot for yourself. Comfortable position, placing your hands to your heart center. Thank you very much for joining me, sharing your practice, finding this harmony, continuing in our mind and body as we move through the rest of our week. Namaste.